Like and subscribe right now, or you're going to have bad luck for the rest of the week. We're all used to watching movies where unreal, fantastic animals exist, but have you ever stopped to wonder where some of the inspiration for mythical creatures comes from? Sure, some fictitious animals may have come entirely from a person's imagination, but quite a few have real-life inspirations. Check out these 10 unusual animals that will cause you to realize real animals can be just as strange as those in fantasy. Number 10. Giraffe weevil. What do you call a giraffe mixed with a flying insect? The giraffe weevil. As you may be able to tell, the giraffe weevil derives its name from its extended neck, which resembles that of a giraffe. However, only the males of this species have a truly long neck, as the females of this species usually have a neck 2 to 3 times smaller compared to the males. The long neck is an evolutionary adaptation that assists in nest building, fighting for females, and territory. What may surprise you is that the giraffe weevil is also a flying beetle, meaning it can take off whenever it wants. Can you imagine this bug flying towards you? Fortunately for us, giraffe weevils can neither sting nor bite, and are therefore not dangerous to humans. However, we wouldn't like to see this fly towards us, even if it isn't dangerous. Luckily, you are unlikely to ever meet them, as they can only be found in Madagascar. Number 9. Markhoor. This animal is the national animal of Pakistan and can be found in Central Asia, Karakoram, and the Himalayas. The first thing you will notice looking at this animal is probably its horns, which, honestly, are impossible to miss. The name is thought to be derived from Persian, where the words are interpreted to represent the animal's alleged ability to kill snakes, or as a reference to its corkscrew-like horns, which are reminiscent of coiling snakes. Unfortunately, the snake eater is constantly decreasing in number and are now near threatened, as it is considered one of the harder game to hunt. If you want to hunt the markhoor, you will often have to pursue them into high and mountainous terrain, which is hard to navigate in. According to a famous hunter, a man who is a good walker will never wish for any finer sport than ibex or markhoor shooting. In other words, being able to hunt a markhoor earns you quite a bit of respect in the hunting community. Number 8. Panda ant. Have you ever seen the mix between a panda and an ant? No? Well, today you are in for a treat. Funnily enough, the panda ant is neither a panda nor an ant. In actuality, it is a wasp. It has been named the panda ant because of its coloration, which, by the way, is a warning to predators that their sting is quite painful and powerful. Interestingly, the females of this species don't have any wings, which makes them look more like ants, which was probably the reason for their nickname. Some say that the sting of a panda ant is able to kill a cow, but none of these claims have been verified as of the date of this video. Although humans have rarely ever been stung, the people that were stung have reported that their sting is unbearably painful. If you would like to stay far away from the panda ant, you should watch out for them in Chile. However, it is said that they have recently been spotted in some parts of Mexico and the southwestern United States. Number 7. Atlantic flying fish. You have most likely heard about flying fish before, as they are quite unique in the fish kingdom. And there is a lot of talk about them as well. As the name suggests, the Atlantic flying fish can be abundantly found in the Atlantic Ocean. Thankfully, even though they are often hunted by fishermen, their numbers are still stable and they are not listed as an endangered species. The flying fish does not actually fly, unlike its name. The correct word for their behavior above water is glide, but oh boy are they good at it. They propel themselves out of the water at speeds of more than 56 kilometers per hour, which is roughly 35 miles per hour. The length they can cover on average is typically around 50 meters or 400 feet, though sometimes with the right conditions, they can cover up to 400 meters or 1,312 feet instead. The maximum height they can reach is around 6 meters or 19.7 feet above the sea surface. Unfortunately, as they usually use this to escape predators underwater, this makes them vulnerable to predators above the surface, such as birds. We suppose sometimes you win some and you lose some. Number 6. Tarsier. The tarsier is one of the animals on our list that is an absolute delight to look at, don't you agree? Tarsiers can be found on the islands in Southeast Asia, specifically the Philippines, Malaysia, Indonesia, and Brunei, if you'd ever like to go look at them. The thing that many people notice first about this animal is their large eyes, which are actually just as big as their brain. In some cases, their eyes are larger than their brain. This requires the tarsier to have unique skull anatomy to support their large eyes and heavy head, while being able to balance themselves while waiting for prey. This animal usually feeds on insects, which it will catch by leaping at them. It also has favorites, some including beetles, grasshoppers, and walking sticks. However, even though they feed mostly on insects, they won't turn down some birds, snakes, lizards, and bats. Fun fact, Thanks to their specially adapted vertebra, the tarsier is able to turn its head 180 degrees in each direction. Number 5. Ocellated turkey. Have you ever seen a mix between a turkey and a peacock? If you haven't, oh, do we have something to show you today! The ocellated turkey is basically just a very fancy species of the turkey family. This turkey can mainly be found in the Yucatan Peninsula, Mexico, as well as some parts of Belize and Guatemala. Their habitat can be pinned down to the lowland evergreen forests, but sometimes they can also be found in savannas, rainforests, and marshlands. Unfortunately, the number of this turkey are decreasing, placing them on the near-threatened rank of the conservation status scale. The reason their numbers are dropping seems to be land use changes and higher than sustainable harvest by hunters in the region. A study conducted indicated that the ocellated turkey made up a substantial amount of the diets of 4 ethnic groups of the Yucatan Peninsula. Number 4. Proboscis monkey. Proboscis is another word for nose, which is one of the things you may notice first when you come across this species of monkey. The proboscis monkey is endemic to the Southeast Asian island of Borneo. The word endemic stands for a species being specifically native to a single geographic location and is not found anywhere else. Their habitat is mangrove forests and the coastal areas of the island. Now, you may ask, so why does this monkey have this big of a nose? Well, this nose functions somewhat like antlers and horns would on other animals. Their big nose can often act as a sort of warning to other males who want to challenge them. In so doing, they study their competitors' features and decide if they want to risk their lives to try to take over the other male's harem. The larger your nose is as a male, the more likely you are to gather up a group of females and juveniles. The proboscis monkey also has a big belly, which has a fun fact attached to it. This species of monkey is the only primate to chew cud like a cow. This means the leaves that they eat go to their stomach, digest a little, and then come back up to be re-chewed. Actually, that might have not been a fun fact, but it was a fact nonetheless. Number 3. Naked mole rat. Many of us probably had our first encounter with a naked mole rat in the famous animated series Kim Possible, where Kim's friend Ron had one of them called Rufus, simply because he was allergic to all other pets imaginable. The truth, however, is that naked mole rats don't really make great pets, because their upkeep is labor-intensive and demanding. So if you dreamed about getting a naked mole rat after seeing the series, you're in for a lot more work than you think. This sand puppy is a burrowing rodent native to parts of East Africa. With its unique features, it can thrive in underground environments. This mole rat lacks pain sensitivity in its skin and has very low metabolic and respiratory rates. Adding to that, the mole rat also has a resistance to cancer and oxygen deprivation. Overall, this is a very interesting animal to look into, even though it may be hard to look at. Tell us in the comments below what you think about the naked mole rat. We would love to hear your opinion. Number 2. Venezuelan poodle moth. What do you get when you cross a moth and a poodle? Well, exactly what we are talking about in this entry on our list. This cute animal seems like it could be a Pokemon. It looks like someone crafted it from wool and attached 2 black beads as eyes. However, the truth is that this moth actually does exist. As the name may suggest, the Venezuelan poodle moth can be found in the Gran Sabana region in, you guessed it, Venezuela. This animal was first photographed in 2009 by a zoologist by the name of Dr. Arthur Anker. He took a total of 75 photos of this amazing species, but only a few of them are actually able to be viewed. Even now, though, some people believe it is a hoax, because there isn't that much information about the actual species. Well, we keep hoping that this species is real because it is just so adorable. Number 1. Tardigrade. For our number 1 entry, meet the toughest animal on Earth. Though this animal is relatively small, it is surprisingly tough. You may be able to spot them with the naked eye, but you'd have to look really close. On average, they measure less than 0.5 millimeters, with the largest tardigrade still less than 2 millimeters. They aren't only insanely small, but also transparent. Now we come to the crazy environments the tardigrade has survived in. The water bear, as it is often referred to, can survive sub-zero temperatures, boiling water, zero oxygen, both radioactive and cosmic radiation, and even the vacuum of space. And they weren't merely placed in a simulation of space, but were actually taken there and exposed to the full space experience. So, why are tardigrades so tough? Well, it is all biological evolution. When the water bear is in an unsuitable environment, it will produce its own antifreeze and a sugar that has remarkable preservation properties. When it does this, the tardigrades become mummified in a glass suit of armor. While in this state, its metabolism is reduced by 99.99%. At that point, it merely waits for a better environment. Pretty amazing, isn't it? And with that hardcore little creature, we come to the end of this video. We hope you enjoyed learning about these 10 unusual animals, and that you may have a higher level of appreciation for how strange our planet actually is. Thanks for watching. Why don't you click on another video to learn about some more cool stuff? See you there!